حي على الفلاح.
Sisters in Islam, after that Allah said, and we gave him the good news of Ishaq, a prophet and among the righteous ones. Allah says in the Quran, has there come to you the story of the honored guests that came to Ibrahim alayhi salam? Three angels, they were Jibril, Mikael and Israfil. They came in the form of very handsome men to Ibrahim alayhi salam and knocked on his door. Now they came in a form Ibrahim alayhi salam is not used to. He's never seen them look like that. So he thought they were real people, but strangers, not from the land. And they looked very righteous. Ibrahim alayhi salam has always seen people who are disobedient and don't want to follow the obedience of Allah. These guys looked righteous. They looked like good, wise, noble people. So they knocked on his door. He opened when they entered his home. So he opened and they entered. They didn't wait for his permission. And immediately as they were entering, they're saying, peace upon you. He replied, peace also be to you. You seem to be a group of strangers. Like, we don't know you, you're strangers, not from this land. Allah says, he went secretly to his family and said, and made immediately a roasted fat cow. And he brought it roasted and ready for the guests. It shows us the generosity to the guest. And he put it to them, and they started putting their hand in there and bringing their hand to their mouth, but they would not eat, because they used to eat with their hands. When he saw their hands not entering their mouth, he knew who they are, and he became scared. He didn't become scared because they were angels. He knew they were angels. When you realize something, but that something that you realize, you wish you didn't realize it. These angels have come in a different form that he's used to, in a different situation. The only explanation that he can think of was, it's bad news. Has there someone in his family done something wrong that Allah has sent the angels to punish? Immediately they said to him, لَا تَخَفْ, don't be afraid. We have been sent to the people of Lot, not to you. We're just passing by. So why did you come? We gave him good news that he will have a second son. He will have a son who is knowledgeable. His wife, Sarah, was standing. Sarah was about nearly 90 years old here. His wife was standing there. She's looking at what's happening. Immediately we told her, the angel said to her, you're going to have Ishaq as a son. And after Ishaq, you're going to live to see your grandson, who's going to be named Yaqub. She was standing there when she heard them say, that you're going to have a son, and after that son, a grandson, his name is Yaqub, like it's set. His wife was standing there, she started to laugh. What did she laugh about? When they said, we're being sent to the people of Lot. She laughed that she was happy that God had now come to deal with the people of Lot because of the corruption that they had spread with their actions. And she also laughed out of relief. We're okay then. And then we said, you're going to have a son, and after him a grandson, Ishaq and Yaqub. She screamed, وَسَقَّتْ وَجْهَهَا, and she slapped her own face, وَقَالَتْ, and she screamed out, عَجُوز, عَقِيم, I'm an old woman, I'm barren. And they said, أَتَعْجَبِينَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ, are you amazed by what Allah can do? Allah will give you a son, he is able to do all things. And so, the angels, when they said all that stuff, Ibrahim alayhi salam was concerned. Like, they gave him the news of a son, but his wife was more happier. And he was still thinking. He was very, very worried. He was worried about the angels going to destroy the people of Lot. He didn't want them to destroy them. It's actually in the Quran. Allah says, thus when fear had left Ibrahim, about the angels, and the good news had been conveyed to him of a son, he began to dispute with us concerning the people of Lot. So Ibrahim alayhi salam said in another verse in the Quran, like, you're going to go and destroy the people, but Lot is there, my nephew. He's his nephew according to the biblical scripture, but he was his family and he was a prophet. He said to them, like, just give him some chance, give him a time. give them some, you know, they'll turn around, they'll fix themselves, just give them time. You know, Lut is there, alayhi salam, give him time, he's doing a good job, just give him more time as well. And then they said to him, they said, we're going to save him and his family. He's not going to be under the punishment. Allah said after he did that, Allah acknowledged Ibrahim alayhi salam's plea. Allah is saying, surely Ibrahim was forbearing, tender-hearted, and oft turning to Allah. Thereupon our angel said to him, O Ibrahim, desist from this. Stop it. Don't argue any more about it. For indeed your Lord's command has come. And the chastisement, a punishment which cannot be averted, is about to befall them. Sarah has a baby. She was approximately 80 years old. Obviously she named him Ishaq. There's not much said about Ishaq in the Quran and Hadiths. Allah says, and we gave Ibrahim Ishaq a prophet from among the righteous, min as-salihin. And we blessed him and blessed Ishaq and everything around him. We also blessed Ishaq and Ibrahim's offspring. But then Allah says, and from among their offspring, not all of them, we have blessed, and among the offspring of Ishaq are going to be children of the future who are wrongdoers. And this is to tell us that not all of the offspring of Ishaq are blessed. Not all of them are righteous. Some of them were righteous, and some of them were non-righteous. And from Ishaq came Yaqub, from Yaqub came Yusuf alayhi salam. Nowhere in the Quran is there ever a mention of that many prophets born from each other. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in Sahih Bukhari about Yusuf alayhi salam, he is the blessed, son of the blessed, son of the blessed, son of the blessed. Yusuf, the son of Yaqub, the son of Ishaq, the son of Ibrahim. Four prophets, messengers after each other. And so they have a special place, subhanAllah. And from them came all the rest of the prophets that we hear about, right up to Jesus Christ and Yahya, John and Zechariah, all of them.